everyone, welcome back to Naomi's Bookshelf. Today we're going to do the alt relatives book tag. I hope I got the name right. Anyways, I was tagged in this by Nikki from Red Dot Reads, and I will link her video down below along with the original tag. I honestly didn't look up who it's by. I'm so sorry. I'm just kind of doing this off of a whim, essentially. So I was tagged in this though, so I really didn't want to do it, and here we go. Another thing about this filming aspect is that I am very spontaneous right now, so I did not grab the book. So we're just gonna put up a bunch of pictures. So the first question is Mamma Mia. This is a book that features a mother that is pivotal to the character or to the story. I actually have it right behind me, so no picture needed. And that is Wives and Daughters by Elizabeth Gaskell. This one is very much based around the fact that this father, Dr. Gibson remarries, and so Molly Gibson has a stepmother. That really pushes this whole book forward. So Hyacinth Claire Gibson is really the driving force of this book. In some ways that are good, in some ways that are bad, but really it's because a mother joins this family. So really Molly has to learn how to live with a mother, and a lot of her life events take place because of the mother that she has, a new mother, a stepmother, and the fact that she didn't have a mother to begin with at the beginning of this book, at least. So I would say that counts. The next prompt is Papa Don't Preach. Name a book featuring a father or that you'd like or despise. I'm actually going to go with these books. So if I don't have a book in easy access, I will show it to you. So this one is The Ray Father. So this book bind up is Betsy and the Great World and Betsy's Wedding, so it's not a great example, but this one might be, which is Heavens to Betsy and Betsy in Spite of Herself. I think Mr. Ray is such a great father. He is always encouraging Betsy to be herself. He's always inspiring them, but he's also just such a funny character to read about. The way that he does Sunday's dinners, I believe, I think that was the night, but he would always just cook up those strange meals. And he would always make the newcomers in the home feel welcome. He was such a fascinating character to read about and such a, I don't know, happy character. He always put a smile on my face, and I loved reading his scenes. So Betsy's father is a great role model, I think, in these books. And he always inspired her love of learning, love of being herself, and he never doubted her for one minute. The next one is Brothers and Sisters. So name one with an interesting sibling relationship, and I'm gonna go with Bluebird and the Sparrow by Jeanette Oak. This one has two sisters who very much are at odds. One of them is very beautiful and charming, and the other one is very much resilient and she feels very plain. We read about it from the older sister's perspective, who feels like she's very plain, but it's just a matter of perspective, honestly. So I really feel like this shows sibling rivalry, sibling relationships, and also shows how sometimes you feel like an outcast in your family, or you just feel those differences, because honestly, I am the brunette and my sister was the blonde, and I could feel Bertha's experiences in this being more bookish, kind of being a little more on the introverted side, while my sister was a lot more charming sometimes. But I definitely did not go down this far road and treating my sister this way, but I definitely think that this showed an interesting sibling dynamic. The next one is It's Been 84 Years, Name a Multigenerational Book. So I'm gonna go with A Home for Unwanted Girls by Joanna Goodman. This one is interesting because I don't read a lot of multi-generational books. I looked at my list of favorites and I realized there are very few what I would consider to be multi-generational books on this list. I read a lot of like time gap books where there's like, you know, one storyline from 100 years ago, one storyline from now, but not necessarily multi-generational. At least, is that multi-generational? Please tell me in the comments. But anyways, this is what I chose, as this follows a mother who, when she was like 15, I think it was forced to give up her baby in the 50s. And then it follows through the years as she was trying to find her baby, but also her daughter growing up in the pre-orphan era in Quebec, not Ontario. And then her daughter growing up also having a lot of trauma and actually going down the line. So it is a multi-generational story, I think, in that regard, and I really enjoyed it. I feel like it showed a lot about Quebec's history and quite a time for unwed mothers during that era. So very sad book, but very important to Canadian history, and often a part of history that is very sad and very untouched on during that era. The next one is You Complete Me, a book that features an interesting marriage. And I'm gonna go with A Beautiful Terrible Thing. This one is by Jen Waite. And this one is a memoir of her being married to a sociopath. And I found this one to be very interesting. It's not the best written memoir ever, but I did really find it fascinating as it basically documents her time being newly married to this man or newly dating this man. And then just after she gave birth to their first child and struggling to, you know, come to terms with what's going on. She's obviously going through postpartum and then seeing what's happening with him, how he's acting around certain situations and realizing that he's cheating on her, what's happening and how this is all playing out. I thought it was so interesting and how she started to realize that things were not quite right. And how he was using her the whole time. So it is a very interesting look at how it actually is for a regular person being married to a sociopath and how she was used through that process and how he actually managed to manipulate her. So I highly recommend it. It's not well known at all. It's pretty much a silent book from people talking about it, but I thought it was very interesting. I think it was well written and I do highly recommend it for that kind of topic and definitely interesting. I didn't remember any trigger warnings on it, although it does talk about obviously mental illness, mental health, and her dealing with the aftermath of that. The next one is Picture in Sicily, a book featuring an interesting elderly character. And I'm going to go with The Great Mistake by Mary Roberts Reinhart because Maud is fascinating. She is the woman who owns this big house in The Great Mistake. And I feel like I'm gonna be stealing Kevy's answer if Kevy does this tag, because Maud is a gem. She is so feisty and so stubborn, but she speaks her mind. She has gumption, she has spunk, she has determination, and she knows what she wants to do with life, even though she's not a spring chicken anymore. I loved Maud. She was hilarious. And I think that this is such a great book to read. And Maud herself is just, she is a firecracker. The next one is Friends as Benefits. So the prompt is featuring a found family or friends as family. And I'm going with The Alice Network by Kate Quinn. I think this is an interesting family of Eve, Charlie, and the driver who I'm drawing a major blank on his name right now, but that's okay. I have not read this book in a long time, and this book does contain trigger warnings for torture and a few things, but it is such an interesting spy thriller mystery about the World War I events, and I loved it. Spy, espionage, such a great book. And I loved how they all came together in this novel and really had to support each other in the modern events of World War II or post-World War II. So these three really found a family in each other, supported each other when no one else was there to do so. I really loved this one, and it's my favorite Kate Quinn novel that I've read yet. The next one is I Think We Are Alone Now. This one is featuring a character who was lost, abandoned, or orphaned. And I think that Jane Eyre kind of encompasses all of those things. She was lost all by herself, trying to find her way at certain points in the book. She was abandoned by her aunt at the school, and she was orphaned when she was a baby. What else can you say? Jane Eyre kind of fits this bill, doesn't she? I truly enjoy Jane Eyre's arc as a character. I enjoy Jane Eyre the book for the development, and Jane as a character is just such an interesting woman. She grows up from being such a downtrodden child. She has everything thrown her way in a bad way. Life is rough on her. And yet she survives. I love this book so much. I need to reread this one day. Not for Victober this year, too many books on the plate, but this book is a good one. So the last prompt is Fur Baby. So this features an animal that is part of the family or plays an important role in the family. So I'm going with The Last Rabbit by Shelley Moore Thomas. And I honestly do not love reading about animals that talk or play main figure roles in books. I don't know why, but I really enjoyed this one. I love this one. It's a children's middle grade, obviously that didn't make sense, but a middle grade fairy tale retelling of Irish folk tales that is about a little rabbit who is trying to find her destiny. Basically, in this book, all of the girls have become rabbits in a family, and when they are taken off the island, once they become truly embracing what they are or what they have wanted to do all their lives, then they become real girls again. But this last rabbit is trying to find her family. That's her dream. And will she become a girl again, or will she stay a rabbit forever? Such a cute book. Loved it. And she, of course, is an animal, and she's pivotal to her family, especially because she turned them all into rabbits in the first place. So really enjoyed it. Yes, highly recommend that one. So in regards to tagging people, I don't normally tag too many people, but I will be tagging Kevi and I will be tagging Berna in this one. So I'll be tagging, say, Kevi and Berna's Bookish Adventures. So I will link their channels down below, and I hope that you both do this tag. Thank you everyone for watching. If you could leave me a comment down below about what's your favorite father in fiction to read about, I would love to hear them in the comments. And you can always give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and you can always subscribe if you are new here, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.